Hi, I'm Kyle Randolph. I'm a product manager here at JumpCloud. Welcome to our tutorial video series.
In this video, we're going to cover configuring single sign-on with Amazon Web Services, more specifically, using their tool called Identity and Access Management. One important thing to note before we get underway is that this is just going to be covering the configuration for AWS. If you'd like to see the configuration for another SSO connector, please see our documentation located at support.jumpcloud.com. Now, for this video, we're going to cover configuring JumpCloud for SSO with AWS, as well as configuring Amazon Web Services side of the SSO integration. Then we'll show granting a user access to an application using groups. And finally, we'll go through revoking that user's access to the application. Now, before we begin, you'll see that we have a couple of resources set up here. We have the JumpCloud admin console, as well as AWS. So what I'm going to do is we'll start out on the JumpCloud side, and I'm going to sign into the admin console. And once I'm signed in, we'll navigate across the left-hand side of the screen over to applications. Now you can see that I have a number of applications already configured. However, for this one, I'm going to complete and configure AWS. So we'll select Amazon Web Services and configure. Now there's a few different pieces to this configuration. First, this is dependent on an RSA key pair. And if you're not sure how to generate an RSA key pair yourself, please follow the link that we've provided below that goes through that key pair creation process. Now, with that key pair created, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and select the pair I've already set up here. So I've got my private key, as well as corresponding public certificate that I'll open up. Next, we have our constant attribute section. And this piece I'm actually going to put a pin in for now because we're going to do the Amazon configuration piece to gather some of this data. Next, we have our IDP URL, which allows you to specify the URL endpoint for this integration, which is up to you for what you'd like to specify. In this case, I'm going to keep it simple and have it set as AWS. And I'm going to specify the same for my display label, though you can specify whatever you'd like for this section. And with that set, we're going to click Activate. And yes, we do know that once we save this, we cannot update the IDP URL, and that's fine. So we will save. Now, one important piece of data that we're going to need for this is the metadata from this connector. That's going to help facilitate the SAML assertion to be recognized on Amazon side. So we'll select the Amazon Web Services and export metadata, which we'll see is downloaded below. With that information set, we'll navigate over to Amazon side. As I mentioned earlier, we're going to be working right out of AWS's Identity and Access Management, or IAM. And so that's where we'll navigate. We'll continue along, and first part of this integration is that we'll need to configure an identity provider. So we'll select Create Provider, and under the provider type, we'll select SAML. I'll specify the provider name of JumpCloud, and this is where we're going to go ahead and take that metadata that I mentioned earlier. So I'm going to select that out of my downloads, and we'll select Next. Now we have our provider name and type SAML. Looks good, so we will create. Now, the interesting thing with the AWS connector is that it's a role-based configuration. So what we need to do is we're going to create a role, and this is going to allow any of the users that we grant access to this Amazon application or to AWS the same role or the same level of permissions to the different resources in that role. So what we're going to do is we're going to select Create Role. In this case, it's a SAML 2.0 federation type. And this is where we're going to, as we continue through this configuration, select that the SAML provider that we just created, which is called JumpCloud. And for the radio buttons here, we're going to grant programmatic and management console access for the SAML configuration, to which we'll see that auto-populates the attribute and value. And let's continue on to permissions. Now in permissions, this is where you can configure on a granular level what permissibility your users using this connection will have in Amazon. And in this case, mine are going to have full admin access. So I'm going to proceed to review. And we're going to title this role devs. So looks good on our end. So we've got our role name, role description, and our association with JumpCloud. So we will create that role. With those two pieces set on Amazon side, we're ready to complete the configuration with JumpCloud. So I'm going to pull open that piece of information we are looking for here, which is our role Amazon resource name, which is our ARN value. And we're going to plug that in here into the JumpCloud AWS connector. So I've got my Amazon account number, and we'll plug in the name of our role, which is noted here with the role forward slash. And then the comma, this separates for the identity provider ARN values. And so same thing, we're going to take and plug in our account number and our SAML provider is JumpCloud. So that looks good to me. So we'll wrap that up and save. Now with both sides of the AWS connector set, we are ready to continue back over and grant users access via groups. Now what I have is a pre-existing group of users titled devs. And what we're going to do here is we're going to leverage this group of users for granting access to the AWS application. So as I proceed into users, we can see that we have three members of our devs team, Barry, Johnny, and Patty. And so what we're going to do is we're going to grant these three users access to AWS. So we'll segue over into applications. And we can see that they already have access to a few of the apps that we have configured, but we're going to bring that in and add Amazon Web Services to that list and save group. Now, what this is going to do is it's going to allow any of those users in that group access to Amazon Web Services. So let's take a look at that. We'll sign in using one of those user accounts, Johnny's. And we can see now we have the list of available SSO applications for our user Johnny. More specifically, we now have our Amazon Web Services. So I can select the application, and now using that dev's role, Johnny is granted access to Amazon Web Services. And since we gave him permission as a full admin, he can access any of the different areas in the AWS console. Now, if we want to revoke that user's access, again, we can just go back over into our groups, and let's take a look once more at devs. So we're going to take that Amazon connector out of this group, and we'll select save. And yep, so we are sure that we want to revoke that access. And now when I refresh my page, I can see that Amazon Web Services has been successfully removed, thereby revoking Johnny or any other member of the devs group's access to AWS. To recap, we covered configuring JumpCloud for SSO with AWS. Then we proceed to the configuration on AWS's side for that connector. Then we proceeded to grant our users access to that application using groups. And finally, we went through and revoked the user's access to the application, again, using our devs group of users. Thank you.
Thanks for watching. If you'd like to learn more about this topic, please navigate to support.jumpcloud.com. If you'd like to reach out to someone directly, you can email us at info@jumpcloud.com. And finally, if you'd like to stay current with our upcoming videos, click subscribe.